Have you ever gotten so drunk that you completely blacked out and couldn't remember anything from the night before? Well, today I'm going to be doing just that. We're going to look at the science behind why we get blackout drunk and how we might be able to get those memories back. So if you're interested to learn more about this topic, or you just want to see me get drunk, hit that like button and share a couple of your best drunk stories in the comment section down below. And if we get a few good ones, maybe I'll even share some of mine. So apparently I'm not allowed to get blackout drunk on YouTube, or they won't show the video to anybody. So I'm still gonna do it, I'm just not gonna post that footage right here, right now. But it's happening. Hey there guys, I'm Jesse Crow, the traveling scientist, and after spending years studying pharmacology, I'm here to help you live smarter, happier, and healthier lives. Why does alcohol sometimes cause blackouts? You're drunk, but you can still walk around, you can still make conversation, you can even still hook up. You just might not remember it the next day. Gotta love those times. This is because alcohol interrupts the translation from short-term to long-term memories. Let's do a quick recap on memory. First, there's sensory memory, what we learn from our environment, and this can last just a few seconds. For example, there's an obstacle there, I'm going to avoid it, and then forget about it. If the information is important, it'll get encoded to short-term memory, like somebody's name, and this can last for a few minutes, but then when you go to address them later, you forget the name because it was just a short-term memory, and don't you hate when you forget somebody's name like that? It happens to me all the time. But that's okay, we don't care about that person anyway. Now, important short-term memories can get translated into long-term memories, which can last for hours, days, months, even years. But alcohol will interrupt that translation from short-term memory to long-term memory. So why does alcohol do that? Well, let me explain. If you watched my video on how the brain works, which I bet you didn't, but you still can, it's just up here. And if you watch it, you would know that memory formation occurs in the hippocampus, which is largely impacted by alcohol. Now the precise mechanism is complicated, but basically, alcohol suppresses the hippocampus, thereby preventing the translation of short-term memories into long-term memories. So alcohol doesn't cause us to lose our memory, rather it prevents those memories from forming in the first place. Your body is just on autopilot. Your short-term memory is still working, which is why drunk people can still make conversation and still fight each other, although very poorly. So how much do you need to drink to become blackout drunk? Asking for a friend, obviously. Excellent question. A study published in 1971, and yes, I realize that's nearly 50 years ago, but it characterized the impact of alcohol on memory formation as dose-related, i.e. some alcohol equals some memory loss, more alcohol equals more memory loss. Apparently it took thousands of dollars of research to figure that out. I could have told him that. A number that is often referred to is a blood alcohol concentration of 0.16, what is scientifically referred to as sloppy drunk. That's legitimately what it says. That's actually what they wrote in this research paper here. You can reach sloppy drunk by having 4 or 5 drinks in relatively quick succession, or just by downing a cheeky bottle of wine. Don't mind if I do. Is there a way to get my memories back? So there's 2 types of alcohol-induced memory loss, brownouts and blackouts. And the more you drink, the more likely you are to move into blackout territory. A brownout involves partial or fragmented memory loss, when you can't easily remember what happened.
Oh no!
But certain things can trigger your memories to return, like retracing your steps or talking with people from the night before.
Wow.
A blackout involves complete memory loss that cannot be recalled under any circumstances. Unless state-dependent memory formation could potentially bring back memories from a blackout. The concept is that people might be able to remember events that occurred when they were intoxicated if they return to that exact state. So if you're desperate to remember what happened last night when you were blackout drunk, return to the exact same location, drink the exact same drinks, and it's possible that your memories could just come flooding back. Or they might not. There's no evidence that this will actually work, but please try it and let us know in the comment section down below. This is science that needs to happen. So how do I avoid getting blackout drunk? Drink slower, drink less, drink water, and eat food. These four scientific strategies will work to slow the absorption of alcohol into your bloodstream, thereby reducing the likelihood of you becoming blackout drunk. So, in conclusion, alcohol causes memory blackouts by inhibiting the hippocampus to prevent the translation from short-term to long-term memories. The faster you drink, the more likely it is to occur, and the more likely you are to do something stupid and not remember it. Sometimes you can bring back your memories with certain cues, but this doesn't always work. And to stop this from happening, drink slower and drink less alcohol. Or drink as much as you want and get blackout drunk. See if I care. Anyway, that's all for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button down below. And yeah, let us know some of your best blackout stories in the comment section down below. Finally, next week's video is gonna be about something else. So make sure you subscribe for more traveling science every single week. And I'll see you guys next Science Sunday. Cheers.
Look, I don't condone drinking. You know, if recreational drugs were tools, alcohol would be like a sledgehammer. You know, it's very destructive. But if you are gonna drink, then enjoy it. Do it right.